Moving on to the Big Ten, and Wisconsin just destroyed Purdue in this game.
We hadn't seen this from Wisconsin all year.
No, this was all right. So let me give you the breakdown here. Wisconsin was a 3.5-point favorite. I thought that line was maniacal. I thought it was ridiculous. I took fell Purdue. On it.
I did too.
And of course, final again, 30-13. They won yardage 342-206. They won yards per play 5.8-3.3. They won drive points, again, for those that hadn't paid attention. Drive points are when you have to drive over 60 yards to score. They won that 21-0. They won rushing 290-13, Chris.
Well, yeah, but Purdue doesn't run the football on anybody. Purdue's been throwing it on everybody. But that, listen, everything about this game, this is the Wisconsin team that we thought we were going to see in September. All right?
Yes.
It just, look, they're 8 weeks late to the party. Okay.
Yes.
They're 8 weeks late.
Yes.
They're here.
So they also won turnovers, which we have not been able to say that about Wisconsin, but they won turnovers 5-2. Wisconsin was still only 1 of 11 on third down, but they didn't have to worry about it. Purdue's only scores were a fumble return and a 39-yard drive. That's it. That's the only way they were able to score in this game. Aiden O'Connell couldn't do anything. You look at, like, Graham Mertz, they didn't ask him to do nothing. Like, they realized that they had an advantage in the trenches, and they just ran the ball. That's it. Graham Mertz, 5 out of 8 passing, 52 yards, like no touchdowns, no picks.
This looked like Wisconsin football for the first time all year long.
Yes. Yes. I mean, it's
a big win by them.
This is 15 straight that they have won against Purdue. And sometimes it's not coaching. It's not whatever. It is just a thing that happens. Purdue against Iowa was the same way, right? Same exact thing. In West Virginia, TCU, same thing. We'll talk about that momentarily, but got an interesting number for you on that one. Aiden O'Connell was 24 out of 32 for 200 yards, 1 touchdown, and 3 picks. Yeah. So this is the best Wisconsin that we have seen all season, and if they continue to play like this, they can beat Iowa, and they can beat Minnesota, and they can beat the teams that are remaining on their schedule if they play like this. I don't know that they will continue to do it week in and week out. But this was awesome. Josh said, although Purdue is known for beating a ranked team then getting blown out the next week. This is true. Flying Hawaiian said he stayed away from this one. And Josh said he lost this one. So I can understand that. Let's see. Casey said, I had Wisconsin money line. I knew that was a setup game. Cheers to you, Casey, for sure. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at Chris B. Giannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.